Hello students, today we will discuss about basics of determinate and indeterminate structure. Here we are I'm giving this lecture for the course of M.Tech Structural Engineering. Subject is Advanced Structural Analysis. Myself, your branch is as well, Assistant Professor, Bidori University, Lucknow. First of all, we need to understand basically what is a determinate structure and what is an indeterminate structure. As the name suggests, determinate means to something that can be determined. So basically here in terms of structural analysis, we need to determine basic forces that are coming onto a structure in order to analyze the structure for safety and designing purposes. Basically, we are concerned with the determination and analysis of various kind of force, secondary, primary, and tertiary forces that are coming onto a structure. Now, first of all, we need to understand what the structure is basically. Basically, a structure is a combination of various structural elements such as beam, column, slabs, foundation. We have seen beam. Beam is a horizontal member that is mainly designed to carry a tensile force. Columns are vertical members, basically designed to carry a compressive force. Slabs are covering that is made as a roof. Foundation are the structure that carry the load of a whole structure, the whole superstructure, and that act as a mediator between the superstructure and the soil. So these are the main constituents of a structure. Structure can be broadly categorized into three parts. First is a skeleton structure. Second is a surface structure. Third is a solid structure. Now, first of all, what is a skeleton structure? Skeleton structure is basically frame structure, basic frame structure, or a roof truss that we have all seen during our practical exposure of these structures. Second is the surface structure. Surface structure are basically, as I discussed, slab, that is a covering that is used as a covering surface of a structure. Slab and shells are also kind of covering the structure, that is a heavy structure also. So slab and shells are a kind of surface structure. A solid structure are basically massive foundations that is used as a mediator between the superstructure and a soil structure. It carries all the load of the structure. So basically, the load is directly transported by the beam, column, slab to the foundation. Now, skeleton structure can be subcategorized into two parts. First is a pin jointed frame structure, and second is a rigid jointed frame structure. The only difference between two of them is that the joint of the pin jointed structure is hinged. That means simply displacement in a single direction, that is a rotation, is allowed in such kind of jointed structures. Whereas in the case of rigid jointed frame structures, the joints are rigid, hence neither they can move in a vertical position nor they can move in a horizontal position, and also neither they can rotate in any of the directions. So they are fixed, they cannot move in any of the direction. Next is basically in term of analysis, if we talk basically from the analysis point of view, the structure is categorized into two parts: determinate structure and indeterminate structure. What is analysis? Analysis is calculating all the forces that we are concerned in a structure in order to give a surety that the structure is safe and can resist all the external as well as internal forces acting onto it. So that is that this kind of thing, the process of phenomena is called the analysis. And in terms of analysis, the structure can be of two types. First is determinate structure and other is indeterminate structure. The concept basically of knowing the calculating the structure, the concept of structural analysis is basically to know all the result stress resultants such as bending moments, shear force, deflection, torsional stresses, axial stresses, etc. Basically, these all are the secondary or primary kind of sort of stresses that act on a structure. The structure undergoes deformation due to such primary or secondary sort of stresses. So, in order to ensure the safety of the structure under these kind of stresses, proper analysis of a structure is very, very essential. Hence, this whole phenomena of calculating all these such kind of things like shear force, deflection, torsional stresses, axial stresses, bending moments, and all is called the structural analysis. It's called the analysis of a structure. And by doing analysis, we are in a situation to say that this amount of bending moment is acting on a structure. This amount of shear force is acting on a structure. This kind of deflection is produced under the this quantity of load in a structure. So by using all these parameters, we can easily design various structural elements such as beams, columns, slab, foundation, etc. in order to maintain the safety, maintain the stability of a structure. So basically, calculating all the sort of forces, primary and secondary, is known as analysis. And by obtaining such parameters, we are concerned to design structural element. The process is called the designing of a structure. Now, what is a determinate structure basically? First of all, I would like to discuss basic equilibrium conditions. basic equilibrium condition. Here we can see there are three equilibrium conditions for a 2D for a plane frame. First is sigma fx is equals to 0, second is sigma fi is equals to 0, and third is sigma m is equals to 0. Basically, sigma fx means sum of all the forces in a vertical direction should be is equals to 0. Sigma fi means sum of all the forces in a horizontal direction should be equals to 0, and sigma m is simply means the sum of all the moments about any point should be equals to 0. Now basically, to maintain the equilibrium of any structure, we can say simply to maintain the equilibrium of any 2D plane structure, these three equilibrium conditions need to satisfy. Similarly, for a 3D structure, these three equilibrium conditions switches to six equilibrium conditions. So in case of a 3D structure, the equilibrium conditions are six, whereas in case of a 2D structure, the equilibrium conditions are three. So determinate structure is basically a structure that can be easily analyzed using the basic equilibrium conditions. That kind of a structure is called a determinate structure. Whereas an indeterminate structure is a structure that cannot be analyzed using the three equilibrium or solely the equilibrium conditions. Some extra compatibility conditions are required in such structures for the proper analysis. These kind of structures are called the indeterminate structure. Now we are able to understand the difference between a determinate and an indeterminate structure. If a structure can be analyzed using basic equilibrium condition, for 2D frame it is 3, for 3D plane it is 6, then the structure will be called as determinate structure. Otherwise, the structure will be termed as indeterminate structure. Now, here are some of the examples of a determinate structure. You can see first is simply supported beam, second is a cantilever beam, third is a single or double overhang beam, and fourth is a 3-inch arch. The figure of it is not here, but we have all seen 3-inch arch. So we'll start with a simply supported beam. How it is a determinate structure? Basically, these are some of the examples of determinate structure. For example, simply supported beam. A simply supported beam is an example of a determinate structure. Cantilever beam is an example of a determinate structure. Single or double overhang beam is also an example of a determinate structure. Basically, if we talk about simply supported beam, then this is a hinge support, this is a roller support. We already know that the hinge support can only be rotated, nor it can move in a vertical direction, it can move in a horizontal direction. So number of degree of freedom or the number of ways it can move is only one. So basically, it cannot move in a vertical direction. It cannot move in a horizontal direction, so it is restrained in two directions. The number of reactions will be two. Similarly, in case of roller support, it can move in a horizontal direction. It can also rotate, but it cannot move in a vertical direction. The number of reaction over here will be one. So, number of reaction at the hinge support will be the number of reaction at the roller support will be 1. So total number of reactions in this case will be 3. 3 minus equilibrium equations are 3, that is equals to 0. So this is a determinate structure. Okay, so if we talk about cantilever beam is having one end fixed and one end free. At the fixed end, the number of internal reactions are 3, because this can neither move in a vertical direction, nor it can move in a horizontal direction, nor it can rotate. So basically, the number of reaction will be one horizontal, one vertical, and one moment. So number of reaction at this end will be 3. Number of reaction at this end will be 0. So determinacy of the structure will be total is number of reaction is 3 plus 0, that is 3 minus number of equilibrium condition is 3, that is equals to 0. So this is also kind of a determinate structure. Similarly, a single or a double overhang beam, it will be also a determinate structure. Next is indeterminate structure. Now basically some of the examples of indeterminate structure are fixed beam, continuous beam, propped cantilever beam, and three hinge arches. Fixed beam having two fixed ends. First is a fixed end and the other end is also a fixed end. The number of internal reaction at this end will be, as discussed in case of a cantilever beam, at the fixed end, number of internal reaction will be 3, one horizontal, one vertical, and one rotational. So number of internal reaction over here is 3, number of internal reaction over here is 3, total number of reaction in the case of this beam will be 3 plus 3, that is 6, 6 minus equilibrium condition are 3, that is equals to 3. So this beam is indeterminate to a degree of 3. Hence, it is a indeterminate beam, because three more compatibility equations will be needed to analyze this beam. Similarly, in case of a continuous beam, this end is hinge, this is roller, this is also roller, this is also a roller end. So the number of internal reactions over here we already discussed. At the hinge, the number of internal reactions are 2. At the roller, 1, 1, 1. Total number of internal reaction will be 5. 5 minus equilibrium condition is 3. That will give the value 2. So this beam is indeterminate to a degree of 2. Hence, it is an indeterminate structure. Similarly, the prop cantilever beam, internal reaction at this end, this is the fixed end, this is the roller end. Internal reaction at this end will be 3. Internal reaction at this end will be 1, total 4 minus 3, that is equals to 1. So this beam is internally indeterminate to a degree of 1. Similarly, 3 inch arch is having a hinge at one support, another support, also a hinge at the crown. So number of internal reaction at this end will be 2, this end will be 2, this end will be 2. The total number of internal reaction will be 6. 6 minus 3 is equals to 3. So this is also internally indeterminate to a degree of 3. Now next is some other examples of indeterminate structure like two hinge arch. Here the number of internal reaction is 2, here the 2, so it is 2 plus 2, that is 4, 4 minus 3 will give the value 1, so it is internally indeterminate to a degree of 1. It is internally indeterminate to a degree of 1. Similarly, a fixed arch, it is also internally, it is also a indeterminate structure. At the fixed end, like here, the number of internal reaction will be 3. The number of internal reaction at this end will be 3. Total number of internal reaction will be 6. 6 minus 3, that is equals to 3. So basically, fixed arch is indeterminate structure to a degree of 3. Similarly, portal frames are also a case of a indeterminate structure. Now next is basically what kind of indeterminate structures are. Basically, if we talk about the ways the structure can be indeterminate, is basically two. First is the structure can be externally indeterminate. The second is the structure can be internally indeterminate. If we talk about external indeterminacy, that is because of the that is a best example is continuous beam frames, as we discussed in the previous slide. Like in case of a continuous beam, number of internal reaction that exceeds the equilibrium condition is the degree of indeterminacy. So that totally depends upon the external supports. So it is a kind of externally indeterminate structure. Internally indeterminate structure we will discuss in the previous in the forthcoming slides. The best example is stresses, where the exceeding members create the internal indeterminacy in that case. And also basically a truss is also example of both internally and externally indeterminate structure, where a structure can be indeterminate due to support reaction. Also it can be indeterminate due to internal member or any other geometrical problem. Now next is externally indeterminate structure. Now this is a case which we can clearly see that here it is externally indeterminate structure, because if we see externally indeterminate structure, that is indeterminate because of the support reaction. Here the reaction is 3, and here 1, here 1, here also 1. Total number of reaction in this case is 6. 6, that is 6 is how it is 6, 3 plus 1, that is 4, plus 1, 5, plus 1, that is 6. 6 minus, it is a 2D frame, so number of equilibrium equation will be 3, that will give the value 3. So it is externally indeterminate to a degree of 3. Similarly, in this case, number of internal reaction is 3, number of internal reaction here is 3, total number of internal reactions will be 6. 6 minus equilibrium condition is 3, that is 3. So this structure is also externally indeterminate due to the support reaction to a degree of 3. Now, if we move on to another example, this is an example of internally indeterminate structure. So basically, in order to understand the internally indeterminate structure, we are concerned with this equation. This equation says m is equals to 2j minus 3, where m stands for number of members, j stands for number of joints. So basically, if the number of members in a structure is equals to number of 2 times number of joint minus 3, then the structure is called the statically determinate structure. But if number of members become greater than 2j minus 3, then the structure will be called as statically indeterminate structure or internally indeterminate structure. So here, due to support reaction, here the support reaction will be 1. Sorry, here the support reaction will be 2. Here support reaction will be 1. Total number of reaction is 3. 3 minus 3 is equals to 0. Hence, we can say that this structure is statically determinate, or we can say it is externally determinate. But if we talk about internal status of the structure, we are concerned with the equation of m is equals to 2j minus 3. So in this case, number of members are, let us count the number of members, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So in this case, number of members is 18. So number of joint will be, let us count number of joint. In this case, number of joints are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Number of joints are 10. So the equation goes on like this. Something, it goes on to m is 18, and this term is 2 times j, that is 2 times of 10, that is 20 minus 3, it is 17. The value, this number of member is 18, and the 2j minus 3 condition gives the value 17. So basically, it can be clearly seen that 18 is greater than 17. Hence, this structure is internally indeterminate structure, whereas the same structure is externally determinate. So basically, this is a perfect example to consider an internally indeterminate structure. This structure is indeterminate due to a one excess member. So if one excess member is removed, the structure will become a determinate structure. So if we remove this member, or either we remove this member, the structure will become determinate, because number of members will become 17, that is equal to 17. It will satisfy this equation, and the structure will become internally determinate. Now, if we consider this equation, this is structure. Now, similarly, number of members in this case are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Number of joints in this case are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the question becomes like this: 15 is equals to 2 times 8, that is 16, minus 3. So it goes on like 16 minus 3, that will give the value of 13. So 15 is clearly seen to be greater than 13. Hence, it is this structure is internally determinate due to two excessive members. So if we remove this member, also we remove this member, this structure will become, the total number of members will become 13. That will satisfy this equation and the structure will become determinate. So this structure is internally determinate to a degree of 2 because of two excessive members. So now we can easily understand that if a structure will satisfy the equation that is equals to m is equals to 2j minus 3, then the structure will be termed as a determinate structure, or otherwise it will be an indeterminate structure. Now next is, this structure is example of both externally and internally indeterminate structure. In this case, the number of total number of now in this case if we talk about the external indeterminacy, the support reaction over here will be 2, here it will be 1 because of roller, it is 1. So if we talk about external indeterminacy, then it is 2 + 1 + 1, that is 4, 4 - 3, that is 1. So it is externally indeterminate to a degree of 1. Now if we talk about internal determinacy, we know the condition. The condition is m should be is equals to 2j minus 3 for a 2D frame. So in case of here, m is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Total 30 members are here. Number of joints are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So the equation goes on like this. This is 30 is equals to 2 times 16, that is 32, minus 3, that is 29. Surely we can see 30 is greater than 29. So this structure is internally indeterminate due to one excessive member. We can clearly see this member is disturbing the geometry symmetry of this member of this truss. Hence, if we remove this member, the total number of members will become 29. So the structure will become internally determinate. But due to the external support condition, this structure is also externally indeterminate to a degree of 1. So in order to make it both internally and externally determinate, we need to remove one member, excessive member, to make it internally determinate. Also, we need to convert one of the joint in such a way that the total number of external reaction become is equals to the equilibrium condition and it satisfies to give the value of 0. Now we are clearly in a state to understand basically how a structure can be analyzed, how a structure can be calculated as an indeterminate or a determinate structure. So now Now we will quickly understand some of the differences between a determinate and an indeterminate structure. For a determinate structure, it can be solely analyzed by using equilibrium conditions, whereas in an indeterminate structure, excessive compatibility equation are needed to fully analyze the structure. In case of a determinate structure, bending moment or shear force at any section is independent of material property. It means that material property will not depend upon or will not affect the bending moment and shear force in case of a determinate structure, whereas in case of an indeterminate structure, material property will affect the bending moment and shear force. Other differences: bending moment and shear force at any section is independent of the cross section or moment of inertia, whereas in case of an indeterminate structure, these two are dependent upon the cross section or the moment of inertia. Simply, another example is this is similar, like extra conditions like compatibility of displacements are not required to analyze the structure, whereas the compatibility equations are required to analyze the structure. This point can be considered to be a part of it, because it says clearly says that a number of equilibrium conditions are solely enough to analyze a structure, whereas compatibility equations are needed in this case of a determinate structure. Now the other difference is temperature variation do not cause stresses. Matlab, it means simply means ki due to variation in temperature, determinate structure is not affected, but in case of indeterminate structure, it is simply affected. So another thing is basically this is what we have already discussed: basic equilibrium conditions for a 3D frame, they are 6, and for a 2D frame, this is for a 3D frame, the number of equilibrium conditions are C. Fx is equal to 0, Fy is equal to 0, Fz is equal to 0, also Mx is equal to 0, My is equal to 0, and Mz is equal to 0. Basically, in the case of a 3D structure or a space frame, the number of equilibrium conditions turns to 6. Whereas in case of a 2D frame, it is 3. That is sigma fx, sigma fy, and m is equal to 0. Now we need to quickly understand what is external forces. Any force that is externally acting on a structure is called external force. For example, applied forces due to live load, wind load are example of external forces. We already know when a force will act on a structure, it will create a reaction. So basically, both force and a reaction, they both are example of external forces. What are internal forces? Internal forces are the forces that generates within a structure due to disturbance in geometry or a disturbance in the equilibrium condition of a structure. These kind of forces are evaluated during the analysis process, and we will discuss it in more detail in the forthcoming lectures. So next is we'll quickly discuss some of the support condition. If there is a roller condition, the number of unknown reaction or the internal reaction will be 1, because roller can the number of unknowns basically is 1. The number of reaction here is 1, because it can move in a rotational way, it can move in a horizontal way, but it is restricted to a vertical moment. So number of unknowns here is 1. In case of a rocker also, number of unknown is 1. In case of link support, the number of unknown is 1. In case of hinge, it can only rotate. It is restricted to vertical movement, hence the reaction will be Ry, and also it is restricted to horizontal movement, the reaction will be Rx. The number of total number of internal reaction in this case of hinge support is 2. In case of fixed support, it can neither move in a horizontal direction nor it can move in a vertical direction. Also, it is restricted for a moment for a rotation. So 3 number of reactions will be there: Rx, Ry, and M. So number of internal reaction in case of a fixed support will be 3. This is a summary of it. If the end is free, compatibility equation will be 0. If end is roller, compatibility equation will be simply del V is equal to 0. If hinge, it will be del v and del h is equals to 0, and if it is fixed, then it is del v, del h, and theta is equals to 0. Theta is the rotation, del v and del h is the deflection for in the vertical and horizontal direction. The number of equation will be 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so this is all for this lecture. Hopefully, you all have enjoyed. We'll discuss further details about the determinate and indeterminate structure and how to calculate the determinacy, indeterminacy of a structure, types of indeterminacy in the forthcoming lecture. Thank you, class.